So I just wanted to show you, this is a picture of the house burning, but it shows you that it's fully engulfed in flames. It was a very intense fire. So everything burned in that fire in our house. Unfortunately, we weren't there, but my son, my older son, was able to rescue our dog. So that felt like a good thing. So everything disappeared in the fire. I think that part of the problem was that the fire behavior was really extreme. So there was really no rhyme or reason to what survived and what didn't. So for example, our house burned, probably the third or fourth house to burn after the fire started. And the garage, which is less than 100 feet away, survived. So that's just to say that the fire behavior was quite squirrely. Even though our house didn't survive, the forest around the house is really in pretty good shape. And I really feel that that's a result of the thinning efforts that we did before the fire ever happened. I'm a research hydrologist with the U.S. Geological Survey, so that means I study water, but my specialty is to really look at the erosion and flooding and water quality effects of fire. So I've been working on this since the 1996 Buffalo Creek fire. I've been trying to be very active in the research that's focused on this particular fire. Literally in my backyard, we have installed many instruments to try to understand how things change since the fire. Here's a nice layer of ash that's still in this area, and it's nice and moist from the snow that we got recently. Underneath it, there is soil that's absolutely dry. So that's why we get worried about the post-fire flooding hazard in these severely burned areas, is that you have lost all your organic matter that can really soak up that water. In this case, they've decided to use both weed-free straw mulch and a product called wood mulch, which is essentially tongue depressor sizes, pieces of wood. They're being quite strategic in applying that mulch to those areas that are steep, that are burned at either high severity or moderate severity. So the first thing I would do as a homeowner, and as you know, I did lose my house in the Fourmile fire, is contact the National Resources Conservation Service. That is the federal agency that provides assistance to private landowners. And they have a bunch of programs available to help you stabilize your burned area. Well, I feel really fortunate in that I have a lot of resiliency myself. And because I am very aware of the danger of living in the wildland-urban interface, I kind of expected a fire at some point in living up there, and we've lived up there for 20 years. I'm extremely grateful to the assistance that we've gotten from the county and from the community. It's just been amazing.